catch fentanyl on your tongue. It's fun.
Sugar.
It's too early. I never eat December fentanyl. I always wait till January.
Ho ho ho! Free fentanyl for anybody!
Ah, look who we got here, Funny Man. Oh, you so funny down there for Christmas. You fucking piece of fucking misogynistic shit. I thought you was working on your wellness. You dumb motherfucker. Yeah. Is that funny? I thought that was pretty fucking funny. You're not laughing now. You fucking not so funny, Norm. You got something to say? You got some funny shit? Hold on, let's see what you got to say.
I'm dreaming of a white guy Christmas, just like the ones I used.
Shut the fuck up, Morgan, when you're on this.
White guys.
Man, my ribs still kind of hurt. That was messed up.
You fucking deserved every fucking kick. I wish I really made contact with your face.
Merry Christmas.
Hey!
From white guys.
I was helping Norm with his wellness. He's not as well as I hoped he was.
You really helped me with my wellness. You did.
Trying.
You dislodged, really, I think, some evil that was...
You're probably going to take a better shit tomorrow morning.
I hope so, yeah. I might not have to take my fiber tonight after that
kick. That bubble gum from 88 is going to come out. I'm telling you.
It's a white guy's Christmas spectacular.
We white, and it's not snowing.
For you audio listeners, I would never tell you to not listen on audio, but we're going to be chock full of video treats tonight, so you may want to go over to YouTube or Rumble and watch the video version. By all means, please continue to listen on audio, but we got all kinds of video specials.
What kind of chalk are you going to chalk it up to? Like, I mean, what color chalk do you use when you chalk it up?
What? How many colors of chalk are there?
They got multiple colors. They got rainbows.
The board is black and the chalk is white. That's
You can do that rainbow.
Wait, no, the board is white now. They changed. It's not a black board anymore. It's a white board.
Oh, really?
And all the colors right on the... I just realized that now.
So now it's not a blackboard.
No, it's a whiteboard. They don't have blackboards in classrooms anymore. They're whiteboards. Never. Which seems a little sus. Like, you had a whole
trying
board.
Trying to wash out the black? What are you doing?
And we took it over. So I don't know. That's...
Well, you could see more color on a whiteboard, right?
I guess. But all the colors are on the blackboard. So I...
No, blackboard's black. With white chalk. The fuck are you talking about? Nah, it's blackboard white chalk.
Are you feeling the Christmas spirit?
Do I gotta tell you the truth?
Whatever you want. You can lie.
I mean, I feel like the spirit I'm gonna give it. I mean,
all right.
I'm not feeling full spirit because it's the first year for everything.
That's true.
So, like, it's a little different this year. So, for me, it's a little... I'm without someone that I would like to be with. You know what I mean? So that's kind of hard. But like, as far as what I'm trying to do.
You mean JoJo?
No, nah, I wasn't talking. I was talking about my mom.
Oh, yeah.
You fucking think it. You know the fuck I was talking about. But that was good. But I miss you, JoJo.
Yeah, for video, you know, listeners, watchers, you may notice. I got the setup here. We're kicking it old school again.
We're not the trifecta that we were
going back
previously.
Back to the beginning.
Two honks. That's it. Two honks.
Yeah. We wish JoJo the best. He's got some family stuff that he's dealing with right now, which Kenny and I totally understand. As I've
prayers,
always told him,
respect.
Family always comes first. And but he'll be back. I'm confident he'll be back. But for now,
it's just important.
It's just the original two.
Two honky talks.
Honkies.
Two honkies talking.
Yeah. So we'll see if we got all of our old technical problems that we used to have in the early days. But
it sounds great. So like far, the last time, I mean, last time we had problems with the fucking shit and I got too loaded, but like,
so far it's good.
I mean, Joe, I mean,
the mics sound good.
I don't know, dude. Video. You might have been too close to the power plant because last time we had some technical difficulties and now it ain't that difficult. But I do miss you with the difficulties or without, with or without.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, JoJo. Merry Christmas to everybody.
Yo, this is for you, JoJo. We're probably going to open it for you while you're not here.
Yo, should we do that? Or do you want to wait?
Nah, I'll probably wait for him. All right. You can just, I ain't going to open this gift. How you fucking going to open someone else? It was a joke. But no, you can't open someone
else's
gifts.
I mean, I can see
you
doing that.
I wrapped the shit. Why would I want to unwrap that? I spent all this time wrapping it. Look how crispy those lines are, dude. That's my feminine hands. That's my feminist.
You do have feminine hands.
Yeah. Feminine hands, soft calluses.
So let's get into it. Do you have any favorite Christmas songs?
I do.
Yeah?
My favorite, Susie Snowflake.
Susie Snowflake.
Yeah. Here comes. You're going to have to play it on the player.
How's it
Here
go?
Here comes Susie Snowflake dressed in a snow white gown. Tap, tap, tapping, poking on your arm right now. She's barely right in town. Here comes Susie Snowflake. Soon you will hear her say, come outside and play with me. I'm not even truly.
Wait, is this some kind of new feminist version of Frosty the Snowman?
I was pulling some Norm shit, but Susie Snowflake's traditional.
Dude, you motherfucking feminist. It's Frosty the Snowman.
No. You'll have to play the real song.
Frosty
really
the
good.
Snow Person? Is that Hold what you're on. Telling me?
Hold on. Let me see if I can find it. Now it's going to mess up my fucking gag gift. I can't. You're going to have to add it in there.
That's fine.
Yeah, I'm going to. I got some other shit going on that you're not ready for.
I got to. Like, I'm a sucker for Christmas songs, man. Like, I love the classics. Like,
that's a classic. That's a classic that you never heard. It's really good. I love it. So that's my favorite Christmas song, Susie Snowflake. Go chime it in. It's great.
I love the oldies. I love the new ones. I love Christmas in Hollis, Queens. Run DMC. I don't know if you know that one.
I don't know that one.
But I've been doing the Tom Petty, It's Christmas All Over Again song. I do that with my kids every year.
Yeah, I don't play none of this shit because it's playing everywhere I'm at. Everywhere I'm at. Like,
I just love it, dude. I play them like from Thanksgiving to Christmas.
Right.
I play them all the time. But I probably... If I had to pick a favorite, it'd probably be something by the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
Okay.
Do you know them?
I'm not sure.
They do. It's kind of like a mashup of like kind of heavy metal and traditional Christmas stuff. But I mean, I love everything they do because you got to figure like, number one, there aren't that many people that even live in Siberia. And number two, they found enough trans people to give them their own orchestra. So that's
pretty cool.
That's kind of amazing. I mean, that they're like,
I'd have to listen to it.
They've got their own orchestra from a place like Siberia, which doesn't even have many people at all. So
is that really a place?
I'm off. Yeah, it's like the northern portion of Russia.
Oh, yeah. They'd send you there. I'd send you there.
Yeah.
How's that? I'm going to send you there. You can hang with all them trans. You can play all that hardcore trans shit you want to do.
But it's, I was speaking of Siberia. I don't know if you know any of the story of the connection between Christmas and psychedelic mushrooms. You've ever dug into that?
I did see some stuff, yeah, because that's how Santa Claus came about.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I've seen that. I've seen like a whole little deal. I don't know where I reviewed it, but like it was good.
So some of it, yeah, some of it's speculation, some of it has some truth behind it, but it's basically based on this mushroom that's called the Amanita muscaria, which is like the classic Super Mario mushroom. It's like the red cap with the white dots on it.
Yep.
Yeah, they grow all over the world, and they come in different colors too. It's not just the red and the white. There's yellow. There's all white. But part of the story is that the shamans in those cultures in Siberia and other places in the upper northern hemisphere would use those mushrooms for psychedelic journeys because they are psychedelic. You can't, they're also poisonous. You can't just eat an Amanita. There's a way to cook it down to extract the active compounds. But so these shamans would gather those mushrooms and supposedly they would dry them on pine trees because that's the only those are the only trees that grow in those upper latitudes. So, right, so that kind of references the idea of hanging ornaments on a tree. They're hanging these mushrooms on a tree to dry them, right? So there's that. And that also the red and white, the colors of Santa Claus and Christmas.
You're wearing the hat. Red and there white. You
I'm
go.
Wearing the hat. What's the other one? Oh, so the other thing is when the snow would get so high, sometimes the only way to enter their huts would be actually from the roof down through the chimney because they couldn't get in through the door because the snow pile
in, yeah.
was so high. So that's another similarity. And then also reindeer supposedly love these mushrooms, but they don't eat the mushrooms directly. It's after a human ingests them and they're filtered through the body and then pissed out. Like a reindeer supposedly will knock somebody over to get to that mushroom soaked piss to drink in order to trip.
Wow. That's wild. That's some Frank Zappa shit. Right
so
there.
That, yeah, yeah. So then it's like, yo. So then the idea of like flying reindeer also supposedly comes from that too. So it's either the shamans tripping, thinking that the reindeer are flying, or the reindeer themselves are tripping, feeling like they're flying. So there's all kinds of flying similarities.
Yeah. Yeah. They're all flying somewhere. Yeah. They might yeah. not have left the ground, but they're flying high.
Yeah. So I love that. Like I said, like some of it is based in reality. Other stuff is just kind of like conjecture or like
it's
ideas
not from
about.
There.
But
I don't. This we're not from that timeline. So
yeah, yeah.
It's anything's possible.
But the idea, the whole idea of Santa is like a northern myth too. So it's interesting that like there's some.
So Santa's Russian.
Could be. I think he's actually more like a Scandinavian. Crossed with German, right? St. Nicholas. We should have done some more research before this episode. I only know about the mushrooms
yeah.
and the tripping.
I don't know nothing about mushrooms or tripping. But I do like portobellos.
But I do have some mushroom ornaments hanging on the tree upstairs.
You do?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. They're not psychedelic.
Oh.
No.
Just dried.
Yeah.
Mushrooms.
Just dried mushrooms.
Boring. How's that going to get the fucking Santa Claus flying?
I got a Christmas song to play.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What's it called?
It's my take on There's No Place Like Home for the Holidays.
I don't think it was home. I think it was oh.
Nothing like a home for the holidays, blowing snow off the ass of a hoe. Oh, there's plenty of hoes for the straights and gays, for the holidays, a hoe. Yourself a hoe.
There you go.
There it is.
Get yourself a hoe. There's nothing like it.
I say no to the hoes.
You say no to the hoes?
Yeah, dude. So,
look, you get a hooker, bring her to Christmas dinner. You don't have to worry about her politics. You don't have to worry about whether she's a Republican or a Democrat. You don't have to worry about.
You need to pause. You do have to worry about the crotch crickets.
Well, yes. But that's probably not going to come up in conversation.
I mean, it's going to come up on something else, but like, I don't know if I want to hoe for a holiday. It's enough of those.
It's the best.
I want to no-hoe for the holidays.
What?
Mm-hmm.
No-hoe?
I want regular eyelashes and no makeup.
That's fine. You can find a natural hoe.
I haven't seen one yet.
I think there's probably a market out there.
Shit.
Yeah.
I want a natural hoe for Christmas. For the holidays.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
I like your, that's a really festive shirt you have on.
Yeah.
For the Christmas episode.
I'm American.
Do you like mine?
It's very Honky Hendrix.
This is actually a traditional African shirt.
Hendrix was black, right?
And I think, yeah. At least 50%, I think.
Wasn't he British too?
No.
I always get confused.
He went over to England early. He had success in England before he came back.
So I always thought he was a Brit from like America.
Yeah. No, he was born in Washington State.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
It's confusing.
Yeah, was in the army.
Mm.
Then went over to England, made it big, and then came back. Made it big over here. But I wore, this is my Kwanzaa shirt that I wore tonight for our Christmas episode, because it's also our Kwanzaa episode.
I didn't know.
It is.
So we're doing Hockey Kwanzaa,
so you
huh?
Do you celebrate Kwanzaa?
I celebrate... I don't celebrate shit. So I'm happy for everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
But what we do when it's like, when I used to like professionally decorate, we'd say Happy Holidays. You couldn't say Christmas because we would decorate for Kwanzaa. We'd have to decorate. We did Kwanzaa.
Okay, Mr. War on Christmas.
Yeah, but we'd have to do Kwanzaa. We did, the other one.
Hanukkah.
Is that what it is? Yeah, with all the candles. Yeah, we would kind of.
Kwanzaa has candles too.
Oh, do they? How many?
Yeah.
Is there a certain number? You fucking better know what your fucking shirt on.
Well, I'll tell you. I don't know if you know. Most people don't know much about the history of Kwanzaa.
Okay.
But my daughter actually came home singing a Kwanzaa song.
Oh, shit.
The other day. And I was like, where'd you learn that? She was like, oh, we're learning it to sing at our Christmas, at our holiday.
Nice.
Celebration thing at school. I was like, oh, really? What did you learn anything about Kwanzaa? She was like, no, we just really learned the song. But I asked my teacher what Kwanzaa is about, or like, what's the point? And she really didn't know how to answer me.
That's kind of fucked up.
So I said, well, let's look it up a little bit, because I already knew the answer to this. So I said, let's Google it a little bit. And we made it to the Wikipedia page of Mr. Ron Karenga, who is a black American man who created Kwanzaa in the 1980s.
That's not that long ago.
So it's not an African, people think it's an African holiday. It's not an African holiday. It was invented by an American dude who ran a group that was kind of a competitor to the Black Panthers back in the 60s and 70s. And the whole idea with Kwanzaa was it was going to be a black holiday, so black people didn't have to celebrate the holiday of the evil white people, which is Christmas.
Pretty cool.
But at the same time, some of the oldest Christians in the fucking world are actually from
Ethiopia. I know.
So
Christianity came way before in Ethiopia. I've seen that. Like, that's the whole deal. They didn't realize, like, it's from Ethiopia.
So, and the other interesting thing about Mr. Ron Karenga was he was imprisoned for felony assault and basically kidnapping. So he kidnapped two women that were from his group, his black militant group, because he thought they were spies, held them in his basement, electrocuted them, whipped them with electric cords, like extension cords.
Yeah, I've been beaten. Yeah. Not by him.
And supposedly, like, I actually found the text of the testimony of one of the women who were tortured.
Yeah.
And she said all that, and also said they beat them in the head with electric toasters.
Were they plugged in?
And so this dude who created Kwanzaa, which is now like supposedly a holiday, but like
I've decorated for Kwanzaa.
I've never
smacked anybody in the head with a toaster.
I've never met anybody who celebrated Kwanzaa.
I don't even own a toaster. That's when that's when I'm crossing the Canadian border, like pull over to the right.
Yeah.
Some of the Canadian border, like they ask me the questions. I'm like, do you want guns, tobacco, money? And I'm like,
toasters.
I've never beat anybody in the head with a toaster. Like, and they're like, pull over there. You got to search you. So, like, that question for me is like, I don't even own it. That was about the guns. I was like, I don't even own guns. They're like, pull over here. Like, I was with Tony. I'm like, they're like, pull over. I'm like, fuck, I don't even own guns.
Yeah.
I've never beat anyone with a toaster.
That's good to hear.
But 2024 is coming.
You never created a holiday either, a bullshit holiday either, that doesn't really exist. I mean, you could argue, like, right? You could argue that every holiday is created.
It's all created,
right?
It's all created.
But Kwanzaa, especially,
I ain't gonna hate on Kwanzaa.
Kind of bullshit.
I ain't gonna hate on Kwanzaa.
I'm not hating on it. It's just kind of bullshit.
Sounds like it. I think we need to beat you with a toast. I was at a toast. I hit you with that.
Mr. Ron Karenga. He's alive. He lives down in Maryland.
I bet we should go visit
him. We'll see. Yeah.
We should go mail him a toaster for Christmas. I'm going to mail you a toaster for Christmas.
Wrapped up in an extension cord.
Oh, God, yeah. We send them separately.
Tied with a bow. The bow is an extension cord. Yeah. Tied
around. Are we doing brown extension cords or white extension cords? Who knows?
Holy shit.
You signed up for this shit.
Anyway, yeah. Mr. Ron Karenga.
So where are we at? We're on the...
Do you want to... Well, I don't know. Did you have a chance to think about... Because we're actually... This is our one-year anniversary. First episode was December something.
Really?
Last year.
Damn, it's 1 year?
Yeah.
Doing this dumbass shit?
Yeah.
I can't believe I'm still here.
So I don't know. I asked you if you had... If you were going to go back and...
I didn't go too far back. I did go back. I did
moments.
I'll be honest with you. When you dosed me with the ass, it was probably my favorite.
That was a good one.
I did see Zappa. So I did do some research, and I'm like, if anything resonated, that would probably be the most fucking insane.
That's our Halloween special for anyone who hasn't seen it. Go back and check out the Halloween special.
The dosage was heavy. I fucking ran into Zappa. I'm like, this is crazy.
Kenny had a full-on psychedelic experience for our Halloween episode.
I would probably say that's probably like one of the best episodes. Like, if I had to coin it, I would say that's probably like the best one.
We kind of went all out for that one.
Like the ghost, like the whole deal, the unwarranted dosing, like
multiple days of editing.
Dude, that's crazy. Yeah,
my back almost went out because I was sitting in a fucking metal chair in Joe's basement while we were editing.
It's like this dumbass couch. This couch is comfortable.
That's a comfy couch,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, but I need a fucking upright chair. I've been fucking Christina. She's been trying to give me this goddamn chair, and I haven't been able to happen.
Yeah, we'll get it.
Yeah, fuck you.
I was remembering, remember Danilo Cavalcante?
Yeah. That dude from Brazil?
So that was episode 16.
Damn.
We gave our buddy Doughboy.
Mm.
I let him live stream on my Facebook page, and then we took that and made that into episode 16. He was driving around the area. For anybody who doesn't know, we had an escaped double murder convict running around in our backyard for a couple weeks.
Until Yoda bit his head off.
That's right. And I actually found the voicemail that the state police sent to us on the day that he got captured, which I never played before. I don't know if you ever heard it, but let's see.
Please do not hang up.
This is a message from the Pennsylvania State Police. The search for Danilo Cavalcante is over. The subject is now in custody.
That was it.
That's it.
About fucking time. It took you 14 fucking days. Yeah. I thought that was the most ridiculous situation. Like, how are you going to put everybody in jeopardy? You fucking had your guy at the tower, like, overlook the shit. Like, he must have got some fucking shit. He got some fucking, what do they call them when you're cooking in there? Like, you can mix it all up. It's like,
Jambalaya?
No. It's called fuck is it called? I can't think of it.
Brazilian wax?
Nah. It's like when you make you mix everything together from the commissary. There's a name for it. When you're in jail.
Turnpike juice?
Nah. You're being dumb with it. Let's go with the fuck is it called? I can't think of it. You can't
anyway.
Make... Yeah, anyway, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know. So that was a good episode. I also remember when I brought you and JoJo a six-pack of Bud Light.
Oh, yeah.
That was a good episode.
That was fucking dumb. That was the dumbest shit.
I was coming home from work today, and I took a little bit of the budget for the show and splurged. So for Joe, this is a late birthday present. For Kenny, this is an early birthday present. So I got you guys.
Let's go.
A sixer.
Yeah, you're Bud Light Pounders.
You're an asshole, but I'll do it. Koozie, hit me.
I gotta get another koozie. That's hilarious.
Is this gonna make our viewership go down 27%?
All right, so I know. I don't care. We're all very supportive of marginalized communities.
I don't even drink this shit, but I'll do it for you. And
you better do it, because if you don't drink that beer, you're transphobic.
I don't drink beer. I drink beer.
You better drink that beer.
Motherfucker. Yo.
Cheers, me.
Bud Light. Joe.
Cheers, boys.
Bam. Clickety clack.
Click clack.
I don't even like this beer, but let's try it. Hold on.
Piss water. There it is.
It's fucking disgusting.
Frisco.
Jesus Christ.
Yo.
I'm going to stick to the Twisted Teas, boys.
This tastes like
the boys. Transformers can have that. I don't want that.
Well. All right. Well, since you're talking about, like, why don't you open that package there? Hold on.
Which one?
That long one that looks like it fucking has a dildo on it.
This long one? You want me to open this right now?
Yeah.
This is for me?
Yup.
From you?
Yeah.
You were playing that on the... Holy shit.
Yeah, bitch. Bud your light, bitch.
What the fuck?
Yeah, I've been doing some work. You think I've been sleeping? Yo. You like that shit? I've been working on it all day.
This.
So yeah, you can sit. It's a sit and spin. It's whatever
Holy
you want it to be.
Holy shit! Did they make this like since the boycott?
I don't know. I was lucky today to find it. It was either this
because or, this is like they're going full in. They're like, fuck the boycott, fuck everything. Like, we are gay as hell.
I was hooking it up. There you go. Play the music up in the mic. Yo, I figured it out today. It was either that or a cooler.
This is so good.
That was a boom jammer.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I thought you'd love it, yo. So I had to cue this shit up, dude. I queued it all up.
Yeah, that's why he's like. This is also the song that Trump plays at his rallies.
Well,
so.
I don't know about that, but it's your business.
How do I turn it off?
You don't. Boys. I'll do it. Oh, there you go.
Is Bluetooth controlled?
Yeah, I got you. I worked on this. It wasn't just...
Dude, that is a special gift. Thank you.
I figured I had to like fuck you over somehow.
That is really good.
Like, I was so excited. I even cut the fucking package out so I could like have it turned on, dropped it in the bag. It's the whole deal.
It's perfect.
So that was either this or there was this gift pack of like a fucking Bud Light cooler that was a boom jammer and like two koozies and a bottle popper. Like, I was like, nah, I saw this rainbow Bud Light. I was like, yo, I got you.
That's really good.
I put some thought into it. And I'm like, Merry Christmas.
Thanks, man. That's fucking special. I love you. That's really
good. I was
so
excited. I've been like, I was telling Dave and Steph, I was like, yo, I'm going to fuck his day up. I'm like, I'm going to hook him up. He has no idea. I didn't tell her the song, though. But
it's amazing. It's amazing.
Hold on. I had to find it. Like, I was trying to think. We had this on vinyl growing up. We had this album on vinyl, like all day. And
it's an incredible song, man. I just watched a full video breakdown. They took it apart track by track.
Yeah,
and it's insane. When you listen to all the parts deconstructed, like, part by part, and how they all work together, it's phenomenal.
I had to come up with something. I was like,
so good.
Merry Christmas.
Young man.
Sit and spin on your own Bud Light.
All right.
There you go.
That was a perfect segue from...
Did you like that?
Yeah.
I did a little work. I didn't chump.
We didn't even talk about that. I wasn't even going to...
You had no idea.
Yeah.
So that's me doing like not sleeping completely.
That's awesome. I love it.
I'm trying a little bit.
One of my other favorite episodes was two gigantic rainbow dildos.
Oh, God. That would definitely.
Yeah.
Yo, everyone still talks about it.
Maybe I'll drop that clip.
Yeah, I would drop that clip. Yeah.
Local news story. Anybody who lives locally, you'll probably recognize this auto garage if you ever drive up and down Route 100. And so they've had these two
figures, these construction worker figures, statues on the roof for years now when they redid the building. And everybody's been perplexed for years. I mean, like, are they going to be holding some kind of sign? Is it unfinished? What are they doing? And I don't know if this was some weird Pride Month vandalism or something, but somebody over the weekend actually crawled up there and put two huge rainbow dildos in these. Look, what? I got a picture.
Whoa, damn.
It's insane,
I don't
man.
Think they're hungry anymore. It's got all the meal going on there.
It's wild.
I'd go there for to get my oil changed.
You can change whatever you want there. They'll change you. Their appointments are booking up quick. So
probably packed.
You got to get in there. The whole parking lot is fucking Subarus right now, I think, after that.
I think that garage is raining men.
White guys!
Now, that was brought up even like out in public. Like, they were like, a bunch of people brought it up. I'm like, they really believe that was a real thing.
Do you want to, I have a present for you.
You do?
Yeah. I got, let me think about this. I've got one actual physical present for you, which is right here. And I have two digital presents for you. And by digital present, that does not mean I'm going to finger you.
Is it from the underground?
It means.
Is it a digital underground present?
It means like, so I don't know. You remember, so listeners, I don't know if you remember, we had talked about, and I don't know if you came up with it or if Gretchen came up with it, the idea for this skit called Curls of Wisdom.
Oh, yeah.
Was it Gretchen or was it
Well,
you?
It was a combination. Like, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It was definitely a thing we talked about.
Yeah. And we haven't done it yet, you know, and I'm sick. I keep getting these emails from listeners being like, you guys talked about Curls of Wisdom like 10 episodes ago, and you still haven't done a freaking episode of Curls of Wisdom.
We'll do it.
So I went ahead and made the first episode of Curls of Wisdom.
Without my
sessions.
Curls of Wisdom with Kenny G.
Your choice of being well for yourself. I'm too busy working on my wellness. It's work on your wellness. Like, you're not well. Like, if you're not working on your wellness. A lot of people are already unwell and they're not even focused on their unwell, personal unwellness. They're unwell mentally. What are you doing? You're not doing anything. If you're like half well, then complain, please. If you're aggressive, you're not well. But if you're not fucking working on your wellness, go fuck yourself. I care about you. I want you to be well. Focus on your mental wellness. I'm focusing on my wellness. Like, if you're not working on your wellness, like, most people aren't even working on their personal wellness, but there's like, I see a lot of unwell people out there. Hey, yo, look in the fucking mirror. Figure your shit out. At the end of the fucking day, just, I want you all to be fucking well and work on your happiness. I'm here for you. Be well or don't. Like, really, that's the deal. Enjoy yourself or don't. We're all trying to figure this shit out.
Curls of Wisdom.
Fucking love it. It's true, though. It's true.
What do you think?
I fucking love it because most people ain't working on their wellness. It's true, though. I mean, I believe that. Like, I see them. They fucking stuck and fucked.
So, dude, I used AI for that.
Did you really?
So, yeah, it's pretty amazing. So,
oh, shit.
It's an AI plugin for Google Chrome. And then I can open up any YouTube video.
Yeah. And grab. It'll
instantly analyze it. And it's really cool too. It'll give you like a synopsis of the video, which is really funny because many times it gives you like a 5, but you can put in whatever you want, but I had to give me a 5-point synopsis of the video. And many times it'll say like there was a humorous discussion between the hosts about whatever topic. So AI thinks we're funny and thinks we're humorous. So,
<For real? laughs>
and so then based, and then I'll give you a full transcript, all the words from the episode, and then I can search. So then I just searched the words well or wellness, and then it'll give me a timestamp of whenever you say that, and then I can go into the video and just grab
that. I'm stuck on that. I'm telling you, it's not a bad thing. That's fucking wild, fun, dude. Man. And that was all AI.
Yeah. So I actually had to go in and grab the video, but AI did all the audio and then told me where to go get the video
with
from
the timeline.
Yeah.
Damn, dude.
Yeah.
That's fucking play that again. It was funny as shit, dude. Holy fuck. Damn, look at my whiskers. That's a trip, dude. Your choice of being well for yourself. I'm too busy working on my wellness. This is smoking your wellness. Like, you're not well if you're not working on your wellness. A lot of people are already unwell, but they're not even focused. That's funny, dude.
You're
unwell
mentally. What are you doing? You're not doing anything. You're not doing anything. If you're not well, then complain, please. If you're aggressive, you're not well. But if you're not fucking working on your wellness, go fuck yourself. I care about you. I want you to be well. Focus on your mental wellness. Focus on your wellness. Like if you're not working on your wellness, like most people aren't even working on their personal wellness. But it's like I see a lot of unwell people out there. Hey, yo, look in the fucking mirror. Figure your shit out. At the end of the fucking day, just I want you all to be fucking well. Work on your happiness.
That's it.
Be well or don't. Like really, that's the deal. Enjoy yourself or don't. We're all trying to figure this shit out.
That's good, dude. That's fucking great. Cheers.
I'm glad you like it. Cheers.
Yeah, holy shit. That's the funniest shit, dude, ever.
It took a little while.
That made me fucking... That makes my goddamn night. That's my best gift, Christmas gift ever.
That was fun as hell.
That shit's fucking brilliant, dude.
So it's...
So you basically... AI did the fucking work?
And no.
You just fucking... It seems like AI was doing it. Like, did you do the work or did AI do the work? So is AI the gift giver or are you the gift giver?
21 episodes.
Okay.
Let's say.
So that I said that shit.
Let's say we average an hour. I would have had to spend 21 hours.
It took 21 hours?
Listening, but no, if I didn't use AI, I would have had to spend 21 hours listening back.
Jesus Christ. So
for every time you said well or wellness and writing it down. So AI did that in about... 5 seconds per video.
Damn.
But I still had to go back into the videos and grab
clip it
and
stuff,
put it all together, and put it in.
I can't have no patience like that. Thank
that
you.
Made sense.
That was fucking hilarious. Merry Christmas.
Because I was thinking there's basically three ways you can go with gifts, right? Like you can go.
Yeah, dude, that's a beautiful. I love it. I can't wait.
You can go practical. You can go sentimental.
Yeah.
Funny, funny, jokey kind of gift.
It's all from practical and funny.
Yeah.
Is the deal.
So this one I thought went for thoughtful.
And funny.
But also funny.
Love
so it hit
the
two.
Dude, you nailed it. Yo, it's fucking brilliant. I'm glad I'm here today because that shit made my whole fucking
yeah,
day.
Awesome. Yeah. Dude, it's been done for a while. I'm dying to post it. And I'm like, I can't post it before I show Kenny on the episode.
That shit was great, dude.
But we'll post it after
now. Yeah, do a little
people,
clip, dude.
People are going to love it. It's so good. It's so fun. I sent it to JoJo, actually. I was like, you can't say anything about this, but
it's so good.
I need to show somebody because I can't, when I finish something.
Yeah, I'm like a child with that.
I
got to
show somebody.
I'm the same way, dude. Like, if I bought a gift there's no way you're waiting until Christmas for that gift. Like that wasn't happening. I came up with that today, executed it, thought it up, fucking queued it up.
Nice.
Like had this shit queued up. Like I put the whole thing in. Like I put the work in. Like I didn't fucking chump. And I was like the first gift was gonna be this fucking Bud Light cooler boom jammer bag, but it was two koozies, a bottle popper. And I was like, and then I saw this, and I'm like, I mean, he's got a speaker, but it's not rainbow colored.
It's not rainbow Bud Light.
And then I figured, well, and then I was thinking, I was trying to get, I could not get my fucking voice to I was going to do Liberace for the fucking music, and then it just didn't work out because I don't spell Liberace well. And
no, it was perfect.
I'm like, YMCA, but I had it was 56. Seconds into the song to get to that point,
right?
Like I did it all. I didn't I took the time.
I appreciate it, man.
I'm Christmas.
I appreciate it.
Look at that shit, yo. So you can actually you can take it out of the box and sit on it.
I will.
Yeah. So where we at now here? Yeah. So yeah, what do I have? Oh yeah, what's my gifts? You want my gifts? What do I say? Oh shit.
Well, we were gonna talk. We're gonna talk about the white guy's gift guide.
That's where I'm at.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm thinking. So for me, it's like spending time with people. But then like the other gift was like the Black and Decker pecker wrecker fleshlight. That's what I had. I'm sitting at breakfast writing this shit down. Like no one has no one knows. I got three drinks. I got the kale drink, I got the coffee drink, and I got the water. And I was like, I'm like the Black and Decker fucking fleshlight record. Like that's what I got. That's what I got. That's what everyone's getting if I could afford it.
Do you have an Amazon link for that we can put in the show notes?
Nah, there's no Amazon link. It's just a fucking smoky link. It's like it's cold out, so it's a George Costanza link.
Yeah.
You don't really, it's probably just a regular like Maglite micro.
Yeah.
Flashlight that you can plunge.
So I got a couple. I saw recently on Twitter, well, it's called X now. I keep screwing that up. It's called X. It's not Twitter anymore.
It's X.
But SEPTA.
I don't swatter.
The Southeastern Pennsylvania Transportation Authority.
Yeah.
Came out with some SEPTA branded gifts for the holidays. Mm-hmm. I think they have like some pint glasses and some other things.
That's cool.
And then it reminded me of the original SEPTA branded gifts, which I came up with, I think, about a year ago. And this is definitely on the white guy's gift guide because these.
Got it?
These are.
Have you ever wanted to bring the exotic smells of SEPTA into your own home? Have you tried sprays and incense, letting your garbage pile up and your toilet overflow, and yet still you're unable to achieve that enchanting bouquet of a SEPTA station? Well, you're in luck, because SEPTA has created a new line of boutique candles called SEPTA Scents. Here at SEPTA, we partnered with the fragrance scientists at the Tacconi Institute of Technology in order to meticulously recreate your favorite SEPTA scents, such as
Smoky Blunt, You're in Luck, Crisp Needle, and Feces Breeze.
SEPTA scents are perfect for meditation, sound healing and aromatherapy, or creating a sexy atmosphere for a romantic evening with that certain someone.
Yeah, what is that enticing fragrance?
Oh, that's the newest SEPTA scent, Abject Failure. SEPTA scents are now available at all stations along the Broad Street and the Market Frankfurt lines. Bring the scents of SEPTA home.
Yeah. So get your SEPTA scents candles.
Oh my God, dude. Holy shit.
Yeah.
I'm getting everybody one.
Smoky Blunt.
Mm.
You're in Luck.
Mm-hmm.
Crisp Needle is one of my favorites. And Feces Breeze. Everybody loves
that. Would be my breeze. That's the one I'm buying everybody.
Yeah.
Are they in stock still? Because I want to buy everybody.
Stock everybody.
That's my brand. Anyone that knows me.
Oh, yes, it is.
Yes.
Oh,
so yeah. It's Feces, you got me. Breeze. Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. You catch it.
And I was thinking, actually, I found another, speaking of like the different types of gifts, you know, like, mm-hmm. What did we say they were? Silly.
Mm-hmm. You said
practical or funny. Yeah. So I thought this one also encompasses two of those. I think this one would be practical and funny too. It's a little,
did they make a smaller size of that because I can wear my own jizzle? It's a little dick. It's too big.
Cozy.
It's too big.
It's crocheted.
Yeah. I would need it like everything half sized.
Well, it allows for expansion. Oh, you don't want to have it on.
When you get old, there's no expansion.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe we could do a custom order. This is, you can find this on Etsy.
Is that like with like Viagra or Hims? Is that with Hims or hers?
or without, yeah. You can find this on Etsy, though. I found that on Etsy. So somebody's making this.
Is it in that box? Because I'll try it on right now.
It's not in that box.
What the fuck? Why you show me this gift? I ain't going to have it. Can you pause it real quick? Because I got to pee.
All right, we're going to take a pee break. All right, we're back. We're going to continue with the white guy's gift guide.
Get them, Tiger.
We just had the Septicent candles. Fantastic. We got another one here. I don't know. Do you know about the Elf on the Shelf thing? What? Elf on the Shelf?
Yeah, they're doing Snoop Dogg now. They ain't doing Elf. Snoop on the Shelf.
Snoop on the Shelf.
Yeah, they don't fuck with them honkies. It's all Snoop.
So this was one. I think I did this maybe a year ago. I think this was my...
Is that recording, right?
What? Yeah.
Cool.
This was my alternative to Elf on the Shelf.
Are your kids constantly misbehaving and heading for a spot on Santa's naughty list? Is Elf on the Shelf no longer instilling fear and conformity? Then you need Joe on Foucault! That's right, Joe on Foucault combines two creepy bastards that will terrify your children into behaving this holiday season. President Joe Biden and French postmodernist philosopher and godfather of critical theory, Michel Foucault. One is known for sniffing children, and the other sexually molested prepubescent boys in Tunisia. Put Joe on Foucault anywhere. In the bathroom, in the garage, or in their bedroom. So if you really want to freak your kids the fuck out this Christmas, ditch the elf and get Joe on Foucault from LGB Toys.
Terrifying. Could you imagine?
I don't imagine.
Most people don't know. So I learned about Michel Foucault in college in art classes.
Never heard of him.
Yeah. So he is kind of the godfather of a lot of the leftist thinking that's going on right now. And, yeah, dude was a fucking pedophile. Convicted. Raping boys in Tunisia. French philosopher.
This is Christmas.
This is Christmas talk.
This is Christmas talk.
This is Christmas talk.
Oh, my God. Can we just put Snoop on the shelf? Because I don't think he's fucking torturing poor boys.
Do you want your other digital gift?
Yes, I do.
You feel
young man.
Young man. All right. All right. Here's your second.
Oh, shit. I can't wait to see this.
Your second digital
gift. Hopefully, it's better than this first one because the first one was pretty damn good.
This is the Kenny G starter pack. We're going to have a link to this.
I almost bought you a fucking Bud Light cooler.
We're going to have a link to this. All these Amazon things in the show notes. So obviously, the top, we got the bucket hat.
Love it.
We got the multi-tool in the middle.
Hold on. Let me flex it.
Bottom right, we got the fanny pack with Sharpies.
Dude, that's my shtick.
Top left, we got various mood lights and flashlights, because I know how you love your lights.
Fucking freak with it.
And then bottom left, we got the cooler bag with beer.
Dude. Yeah.
We are connecting. You almost got me the same thing.
I almost bought you a cooler bag that had built-in speakers with two beer cozies and a fucking beer popper. That's fucking hilarious, dude.
That's the only thing I didn't put on there were the koozies. I could have put on multiple beer koozies.
You should have. You fucked up. But all these things they're true besides the Bud Light cooler. I almost bought you a Bud Light cooler. I should have took a photo of it. Ridiculous. But I like the bottle with the speaker better with the flashing rainbow lights because I know how you get into that gay shit.
All right, so let's go back. We had the three possibilities for gifts. We had the...
You fucking suck. You said...
Tell me.
Thoughtful, practical, and funny.
Thoughtful, practical, and funny.
Phony.
All right. We've already done thoughtful and funny for sure.
Right. Hell yeah.
So this is your practical gift.
Oh my God. It's gotta be a dick koozie. Hold on. Is it breakable?
No.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh, yeah.
You rap like a gay person, too, like me.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Oh, it's a prime box. Damn, it wasn't open? So this was like direct ship, non-open?
No, it was open. And then I wrapped it again.
Motherfucker.
I didn't want,
oh, it's
like
got
the,
batteries the, in it. It's got batteries. Hold on.
Be careful.
Batteries.
Be careful.
Hold on. Let me get my multi-tool. Oh, here it is.
There's some child.
Here's the multi-tool he's talking about. He ain't fucking lying.
Child slaves from the Congo mine some.
Is there cobalt in here?
And lithium.
Like nirvana lithium? Like lithium?
Yeah.
Is it like Rush?
Rush the band?
No, that stuff you sniff.
Snuff?
No.
Rush.
It's like a jar of stuff. You just stick it with like a little cotton ball.
I don't know.
That's some 70s shit. I went back to the future and found out. Hold on, let's see what we got. Did I put my glasses on?
No, you don't have to. This is the practical gift, remember. Yeah, this is the practical gift.
Yo, this is my battery, you son of a bitch.
It's a brand new one.
Is it? It's not even fucking charged.
It's brand new, you got to charge it.
You son of a bitch.
It's brand new. It's not one of your old ones, it's a brand new one. It's brand new. That's a box that came in from Amazon.
This looks like my battery.
Jesus Christ. You're welcome.
Thank you. No, it's not my battery. I recognize not mine.
Yeah, there's no paint on it.
That's right. There's no fucking paint on it. Hold on. This smells like from the Congo.
It smells like Congo, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It smells like the tears of Congolese children, does it not?
And then we're going to steal the energy from like the Limerick Power Plant to charge it up. Yeah. That's the deal. I love it.
Yeah.
Can I sit on it?
You probably can.
Oh, no.
It's not. You're not going to get as much as I will.
Oh,
from
no.
This,
the colors aren't there. It's just one bar. There's one bar. Go. Hold on.
Once if it's fully charged.
Do you
want
to dock it? Let's dock it. Flip that over. Like, dock it. Go ahead. Tippy toe. Not the back end, the front. You can't dock it from the back. You got to dock from the front. There you go.
Tip
winning.
To tip.
Tip to tip.
No, wait. It should be this.
Oh, charge. You fucking idiot.
Merry Christmas. That's good. They can take a little fall. There you go. Side to side. Side saddle.
Side saddle.
That's what you like.
I love the side saddle. It's my favorite.
So the other thing I was thinking, like the... I thought about making you a photo collage of all our trips to Rehoboth Beach.
What happened with that?
I just ran out of time. Like I did the Curls of Wisdom. I did the Kenny G
Beautiful.
Starter Pack.
Love it.
You know, all the other videos. And I was like, yeah, that would be funny. But I did the too funny and sentimental.
I thought you would do the video your mom recorded of the Bud Light ordering. I was so pissed. Like, I ain't drinking that shit. So, like, when I read the whole deal, like, I was like, he's definitely doing, like, the fucking mama fucking Dukes, like, recording me. You recording you, like, order me a Bud Light in Delaware.
That was fun.
That was fun, dude.
Yeah. You can see that on our Instagram and our TikTok.
Your TikTok.
And if you subscribe to our Patreon, which is patreon.com/WYTGYS, you can get more of this and you can allow us to create more of this bullshit content full time, maybe. Because that's my wish for 2024, is that we can actually start to make a little bit of money off of this bullshit. And
that'd be cool, man.
Not work our regular full-time jobs. Because here's the thing. There's plenty of content creators out there and podcast people who do it full time, you know, and they're great and funny and we love them all. But like, we're trying to do this while we're still working full time jobs and, you know, managing all the other things that we have to manage in our lives. And
trying to work full time.
Got any paintwork?
Yeah.
I'm not as full time as I'm gonna be.
The other thing is not necessarily Christmas related, but it's kind of like end of year related. The Oxford Dictionary every year comes out with their word of the year.
What's the word?
And I don't know if you did you hear anything about the word of the year this year?
I can't wait to hear it. Go ahead.
It's, dude, it's honestly, it's fucking depressing. It's like, it's another example of the retardation going on in our culture.
You sure not the retired or the retarded?
You could call it retired if you want to call it retired, but the word of the year is Riz.
What the fuck is, what's the definition?
So
that sounds like some Wu-Tang shit.
I'm gonna read it for.
Is that so, Rizzo? Like Rizzo or yeah. Lizzo? Wait, like Riz is
Frank
that,
Rizzo.
You fucking crumb bum.
Yes, I'll read the definition. I've heard
Riz.
I've heard my
that's,
kid. I've heard
that's
my
the
kids.
Word of the fucking year, Riz.
And my
Riz. Let's go. Let's hear this shit.
My sweet niece talk about this, but here it is. According to this article about the word Riz, which is a shortened version of charisma, is Oxford's word of the year 2023. The dictionary publisher unveiled this word this past week. Riz beat out a slew of other popular words, including Swifty, shorthand for fans of Taylor Swift, obviously, and situationship, a romantic or sexual relationship that's not established or formal, to take the top spot. All right, so there we go. The other two words that it beat out are equally retarded. Okay, so Oxford's official definition of Riz is style, charm, or attractiveness, or the ability to attract a romantic or sexual partner. It can also be used as a verb, such as to riz up a person, which means to attract, seduce, or chat them up. The term first arose from gaming and internet culture, with YouTube and Twitch streamer Kai Cenat popularizing it in 2021.
I would change the R to a J, so, and then it could work in the Oxford.
Yeah.
Or to, like, you receive it onto your Oxford shirt. So subtract the R, add the J onto your Oxford, and what do you got? A fucking mess all over your shirt.
Yeah. Honestly, I don't mind the word.
I just don't like that they fucking, like, made it a word.
What I mind is that,
like, that's the word of the year?
It signifies, like, this degradation of our culture. Like, that is the word of the year? Fucking Riz?
Riz.
Like, I don't want to say it pisses me off, but
Riz is what it is.
I feel like it depresses me more than anything. It's like, that's the word of the year. That's what, like, the Oxford Dictionary, the fucking University of Oxford,
trying to stay current.
That's the word of the year.
I'm not going to lose sleep over the word of the year.
No, I'm not either.
And it doesn't affect me. I don't feel angry about it, but go ahead, shoot.
But, like, with all the advances that we're making, right? With all the scientific advances, with all the technological advances we're making, with everything that's going on, there's so many good things going on in humanity. In 2023.
Yeah. Oh yeah, go. Okay.
And
I'm laughing
concurrently
with
that is this movement to consciously make people dumber. And I would argue that this word of the year is aligned with this movement to make people dumber. Mm. To make people less literate, less educated, less informed about the world, and we're highlighting something that was popularized by a Twitch streamer and a YouTuber as a word that is about being attractive or sexually, like, do you think I'm off base? Like, to me, it just seems so
you're not wrong.
Literally, just stupid.
You're not wrong, but I look at like how I process shit is that I don't buy into any of this shit, and I'm just trying to live a good, positive life. Like, I don't.
But what are your thoughts about the word Riz?
I would change the R to J.
Riz. No,
I would
honestly.
Riz. It makes me think of, like, if it's like a part of a lyric into a, like a Wu-Tang song.
Right.
Or the name of the MC.
Which Riz is great. One? Wu-Tang is amazing.
But as far as like it
but
being addiction.
The word of the year. Across the English language, the whole English-speaking world, this is the word of the year that we're going to celebrate.
I always thought the bird was the word.
The bird is the word. Yeah. Have you heard?
No. I'm just saying, like, now Riz is definitely not a word. Like, yeah, I wouldn't think Riz is like the word of the year.
I wouldn't think so either. It's just, it's kind
of. I got the word of the year.
Please make it better than that.
Focus on your wellness.
Focus on your what? That's four words.
Yeah, but fuck the Riz.
It's depressing, man.
I don't worry about none of it, dude. I'm already depressed. It doesn't fucking matter.
Yeah, and like I need something. I don't know. It's our Christmas episode. I need some. Go ahead.
What would the word of the year? So you don't like the Riz.
Yeah.
So with that fact happening, you already don't like it. What would your word of the year be if you had a word for the year? So, like, take your time. There's no rush. Think
my
about
word
it.
Of the year.
Like honestly, like, seriously. Not joking. Like seriously.
My word of the year would probably be...
Better than Riz. Like, what would it be? Shoot. Go. I'm waiting.
Maybe insurrection?
Stop it. Come on. Seriously. No, seriously. What would be a good, like, authentic word that you would, like, give to the world other than the Oxford word? Like, think about it. You don't have to have it right now. Think about it. So they have their word, and they used it.
Yeah.
Like, what would you come that would be better than the Riz?
Better than the Riz? How can you be better than the Riz?
You're not liking it for the Oxford word. Like, let's. What do you?
It's been
have?
Endorsed by Oxford. How can you be better than the Riz? You can't.
I've
be
never broke
than
bread with Oxford. I don't know Oxford. Yeah. I know there was a sock and a shirt and a fucking pair of shoes. Like, I don't know.
Right.
Like Oxford shirt.
They should have stopped.
That was
there.
Like Tom fucking Cruise back in like, you know, fucking Dirty Business, whatever the fucking out. Whatever was the movie? Risky Business. Whatever.
I think it was called Dirty Business.
Risky Business, but you know what the fuck I'm saying.
Yeah,
Dirty Business. Like, he wore an Oxford and he danced in his Fruit of Looms. Like,
right,
that was better.
That was about anal sex, right? Dirty Business, that movie.
Nah, I think they stole the fucking crystal egg off the mantle. That's all I know. Like, I mean, he was hanging out with some. What's your song? Like your Christmas song?
Hose.
Yes, that's what he was hanging out with, and they stole everything.
I need a song to make me feel better from this. Really.
Okay.
I need something that's going to
uplift your wrists. They're going to rise you up.
You it's know, too
risky business.
I need something that's just going to just bring me back. I feel like I'm straying from the Christmas spirit. I'm getting pissed off. I'm getting frustrated. I'm getting like, fuck this world. I can't believe the fucking retarded, idiotic world that we're living in right now. And I don't want to feel that way.
The cool thing about you being pissed off
for
is
our Christmas
you being
episode.
Pissed on. Like, that's the difference. So, like, you're pissed off, but you're not pissed on.
I'm not, but I don't want to feel this way for a Christmas episode. I don't want to.
What are you going to do about it?
I want to watch a video. That's going to make me feel better.
And bring
me back into the Christmas spirit.
Shoot it. Let's go.
Okay.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love said to me, my pronouns are Xerxes. On the second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me two illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zerzy.
On the third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me,
we're hearing now, three bank failures,
two illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zerzy.
On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me,
excuse me, excuse me, excuse me, I've got more of these than anybody. Four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens,
and I really just hope you can respect my pronouns.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me five drag queens,
four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zerzy.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
six COVID shots,
five drag queens,
four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens.
Guys, it's really simple. If someone tells you their pronouns, you just use them.
On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
seven bills to Ukraine,
six COVID shots,
five drag queens.
Look, four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zer and Z.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
8% inflation,
seven bills to Ukraine,
six COVID shots,
five drag queens.
Would you believe four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens?
It says it right there in my Instagram profile, Zer Z.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
nine trannies dancing,
we're seeing 8% inflation,
seven bills to Ukraine,
did you get your booster shot,
five drag queens.
Can you believe four Trump indictments,
three bank failures,
two illegal aliens?
It's really not that hard, Sir and Z, Sir and Z.
On the 10th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
10 pedos sniffing,
9 trannies dancing,
8% inflation,
7 bills to Ukraine,
6 COVID shots,
5 drag queens.
Would you believe 4 Trump indictments,
3 bank failures,
2 illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zerzy.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
11 groomers grooming,
10 pedos sniffing,
9 trannies dancing,
8% inflation,
7 bills to Ukraine,
6 COVID shots,
5 drag queens,
4 Trump indictments,
3 bank failures,
2 illegal aliens.
Do you get it now? I told you 11 days ago, Sir and Z.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
12 million genders,
11 groomers grooming,
10 pedos sniffing,
9 trannies dancing,
8% inflation,
7 bills to Ukraine,
6 COVID shots,
5 drag queens.
Would you believe 4 Trump indictments,
3 bank failures,
2 illegal aliens,
and my pronouns are Zer and Z.
Thanks for sticking with us with that one. That was over 4 minutes.
Fuck me. That's it. So
no, in this age when we're our attention spans are down to seconds.
60. That's it. Less That's than too a minute. Fucking long.
Less than a minute.
And my name is KNG.
Yeah, it is.
Oh God, that's good.
I asked you guys to stick with us for that and you did.
They stick stuck.
Over 4 minutes.
That was 4 minutes.
And I feel better. I do feel better now. I'm back. I'm back in the Christmas spirit.
Okay.
I was feeling down.
You're over the Riz. You're over the Riz.
I was feeling negative with the fucking Riz.
Yeah.
Just feeling just the idiocy of our contemporary culture. And I feel better now. I'm not sure why I feel better after that video. Because that could bring you down too. But I just...
I think it's like...
from my perspective, it's like you're into sucking your own dick on that shit.
I am.
Because you put a lot of work into it.
I did.
So it,
that, took some time.
You could tell.
Not only just to record the audio, but then to do the video too.
How many hours you got in that?
5 drag queen.
So 5 about, drag queen hours.
About
okay.
5 drag queen hours. Yeah.
Damn.
I think it was worth it. I'm happy with it. I think
I like the drag queen in green like that.
I know you do. Yeah.
You could.
Yeah.
I can feel the riz. I mean, with a J.
Oh, man.
Christmas.
We got, I don't even know, I don't think the tree, our little Charlie Brown tree, translates too well to the video with the colored lights. So we got the colored lights on the drum kit. We got
that
the white.
That sounds very racist.
We got the white Continue. Lights on the tree.
The colored lights.
The lights of color.
There you
Excuse
go.
Me. The lights of color. Excuse me. Lights of color. I'm very big with the lights of color. Mostly very big with the white lights. So I don't know. Like, so my parents were definitely not racist at all. I don't remember ever hearing anything racist.
They didn't run cross country or anything?
No. They didn't run at all. No.
No short jaunts, just regular...
Regular white...
They didn't run fast. They just ran slow. They were just regular.
Just regular white suburban / rural
Anglo-Saxons?
Parents. Yeah. But they did always... Like, we always had white lights on the tree. And as a kid, like, colored lights are always a little more interesting.
Right.
And I always asked about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, like it got a little more riz to them.
But the thing was, the explanation to me was always that like white lights are classy, but colored lights are trashy and more like
what?
Almost like cartoonish or like circusy colored lights. White lights on a tree, it's a classy tree.
Colored what do you have on your tree upstairs? Are they colored or are they white?
They're white. First time this year, actually. Up until this year, I always did colored lights. And for this year, I was like, maybe we'll change it up.
All honky.
Go all honky lights.
Oh, honky lights. Is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I don't know. I like both. I mean.
Well, dude, like I'm not like wearing all white, so I kind of like color.
I love color, even though I can't see all of them.
I think that's probably the problem.
I try my best.
Like, how can you tell that they're colored if you can't see no color?
Well, I don't see color.
Okay. Then how do you know they're colored?
I'm just based on the packaging, because I bought them, and it said colored lights. The same way, like, when I was a kid, my mom, like, once we figured out that I actually was colorblind, my mom remembered, oh, you used to read the names off of the wrappers on the Crayola crayons, used to read the colors so you knew which color to color the thing. Because I read early, so I'd read the color and then I would know, oh, this, and I knew this thing is supposed to be blue, this thing's supposed to be green, this thing's.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So glad I'm not you. I mean, as far as the colorblind.
I mean, I wish we would all push towards more of a colorblind society. It'd be great.
Touché. That was good.
I mean,
yeah.
That's where I feel like we're working in the opposite direction. We're like color is becoming more and more important instead of less and less important. You know, like I think we've said it before multiple times on this podcast. It's like your color to me is one of the least important things about you. It doesn't tell me anything
your
about
you.
Your
outer shell means nothing. It's what you're
your
in.
Your color.
Like, yeah, it doesn't fucking matter.
Your melanation tells me nothing about you. Tell me what you believe in. Tell me what you think. Tell me what you love. Tell me what you hate. Tell me those things. That means something. the color of your skin,
nothing
tells me nothing. Unless I'm a fucking racist. If I'm a racist,
oh, yeah,
then the color of your skin tells me a lot about you.
Yeah. I hate you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or you think this way, or you vote this way, or you believe this. That's what it tells me. If I'm a racist, if I'm somebody who's focused, hyper-focused on color. If I'm somebody who's not, then it means nothing.
Like, I focus
Tell me who you are.
I focus on this. You're either a good fucking human or you're a bad human. The color don't matter, dude.
Yeah.
You know your fucking truths. Like, shut the fuck up. Like, at the end of the day, you know if you're lying to yourself or you're honest with yourself. Like, that's how I look at life.
Right.
I know when I'm lying to myself and I know when I'm not. Like, I know when I'm being real or when I'm not being real. That's it. It's really just being honest with yourself. Once you, like, live that life, like, then you're living. Like, that's it. Be honest with yourself. Focus on your wellness. But that was good.
It was good, right?
Dude, loved it, dude. You kidding me, dude? Because that's the truth. That's what I'm trying to live.
Curls of wisdom.
Oh, my God. That's better than I could have done it.
With Kenny G.
Oh.
Do you want to hear some other curls of wisdom?
Yeah, good. You got some more shit? What do you got?
So it's not as good as that, but it's kind of a combination of what we were just talking about. So I was at Target with the kids. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's Christmas time. Christmas shit's out.
Yeah.
Black
Nutcrackers and Black Santa's got.
My daughter's been really into hot chocolate, obviously. It's winter time. Well,
fucking A. Marshmallows.
With or without mushrooms.
I mean marshmallows, yeah.
If we have marshmallows, for sure, marshmallows. But she found this cute little cat mug, and right next to it, there are these mugs with Santa faces on them, you know. And she looked at the one, it was a regular Santa, and she looked at the next one, and it was a black Santa.
What's a regular Santa?
A white Santa.
Okay.
And then she looked at the next one, and it was a black Santa.
Yeah.
And I saw it before she saw it.
Yeah.
And I was like,
observing what she chose.
I was like, I'm
curious.
It was one of those moments like, I really want to see what happens here. I'm not going to say anything.
Yeah.
And she saw it, and she looked back at me and gave me like almost one of those like dog looks where like the dog tilts its head.
Yeah.
And I just looked back at her. I didn't really give her a response. And she picked it up and she was like, "Dad." And I was like, "Yeah." She said, it's a black Santa.
Yeah.
I said, "Yeah." And she said, "Well, I guess everybody has to be included. But if you know my daughter, you know she said it in a really smart-ass way." And we talked about it, and I said, "Well, you know, like, there aren't that many brothers who are living up in the North Pole, in the Arctic. Because why would they? I mean, why would white people even live up in the Arctic? It's fucking cold."
Yeah.
And and then the other thing was like, well, I feel like we could make a trade, right? Like, I'm willing to make a trade. If you want to, and I don't even think this is something that black people want. I think this is something that the culture outside is pushing. Like, I've never met a black person that was like, "Santa needs to be black."
I saw an Archie Bunker thing. Sent it to Carl. It was a black Santa. It was really good. Yeah. It's like fucking great.
But I've never heard a real, actual human being complain about Santa being white. All I've seen is the mass media and other people pushing.
It's business as usual, dude. It's like, right. You know.
So, I mean, we talk about, you know, white people taking black culture and changing black culture, but we're talking about, like, basically a historically white
Saint Nicholas
person, even though it's a mystical person, probably a white guy if he's coming from the north. Right. They're not, as I said, they're not a lot of brothers living in the North Pole.
North Africa. You motherfucker. There's North everywhere.
But like what? So if it was black Santa, like what would you list? So we'd leave like milk and cookies out for Santa. If it was black Santa.
Stop it.
What are you leaving out?
Go 40.
Blunt, God, a no. Blunt and a 40?
Stop.
You said it.
Fucked up. No, I was just joking. I'm down with Black Santa.
When Black Santa comes, he takes your shit instead of leaving presents for you. You come down.
That's fucked up.
Right? No, look, I'm going to propose a trade. Proposing a trade.
Who the fuck made you boss?
Black Santa. Even though I don't think any black people actually want Black Santa, we'll give Black Santa. We get white LeBron. That seems like a fair trade. You can get Black Santa, even though, as I said, I don't think any black people actually want Black Santa. I think it's a fucking figment of the mass media and commercialism that it's created this thing. But if we're going to make it a thing, let's make it a fair trade. You get Black Santa, we get white LeBron James. From now on, LeBron James is white, Santa's black. Fair trade?
You're tripping, bro. You're out of your fucking
mind. It seems
mind.
Like a fair trade.
Yeah.
Right?
Santa Claus don't play basketball. I don't even like basketball.
And LeBron ain't bringing anybody presents, so.
I'm sure he brought him turkeys on Thanksgiving. He's a give back. I'm sure he did something, dude. He got money.
Yeah.
Some of these cats do stuff for the community.
Some of them do.
I can't say everybody does stuff for the community. I mean, I know some folks ain't got our back.
Larry Bird didn't do shit for me.
Larry Bird. He didn't give me no fucking Irish potato.
Larry Bird didn't do shit for the
white
people.
I'd hit you with the fucking shillelagh, bitch. Fuck out.
Kevin McHale didn't do shit for the white community.
I like
fucking Joe Montana. What the fuck did Joe Montana do for us?
I think he did like the commercials for like when you get old shit. Like you can yeah. like get better insurance or something. I think that's what he did.
No, that was who's doing that right now? Is it Tom Selleck?
It's a whole bunch. Nah, he's doing the dude? He's doing some house shit. He's doing the thing where
the
you
reverse
could, like,
mortgage, right?
Yes, I fucking love it, dude.
Fucking Tom Selleck.
My mom
people.
Loved Tom Selleck.
Yeah, and now he's like
only when he was in the OP shorts in Hawaii,
right?
On Magnum PI.
But now
he's
convincing
could see his like dizzle a little right. bit.
But now he's convincing old people to do
like
a
where his corduroys
mortgage.
Were like not corduroy, like his business would like make him like. Regular pant, like it was just like that's when my mom loved Tom Selleck. Now he's doing the fucking reverse mortgage. She doesn't even have a mortgage anymore.
Right.
It's gone.
Yeah. Well, she's in better shape than somebody who's gonna get bought into a Tom Selleck bullshit reverse mortgage and end up losing.
Is it bullshit? Is it bullshit?
Oh yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
It's bullshit.
He's trying to fuck all these old people without fucking them.
Who loved him for years, watched him for years, and now he's like, yeah, you're old.
And his loner Ferrari, like, that's how he did it. Like, it wasn't even his. It was Higgins. It was Higgins' fucking Ferrari. It wasn't even his. I mean, he had the short shorts. Those were his.
Yeah.
But the Ferrari was on loan.
Exactly.
And the property that he never owned, and now he's trying to fucking tell people that...
Yep.
The reverse mortgage is in their benefit.
Yep.
He never owned a fucking house.
Yeah.
He was riding Higgins' dick.
Right.
Merry Christmas. I'm not wrong.
You're not wrong. Yeah.
I'm just white.
The same way Black Santa never earned that sleigh. You know?
Don't be fucking with Black Santa. Dude, stop.
Have you seen the rims on Black Santa's sleigh, though?
I think he had like Pep Boy spinner rims.
You hear the subs? You hear the subs
stop,
in the back of that
dude,
Black Santa sleigh?
You got to stop. Now, I saw Black Santa, and he was on fucking Archie Bunker. And I'm going to send you the video.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, it's good. I keep sending shit to Carl, dude, all day. Nice. Like, I don't stop. He don't respond, but like I said, I'm all... We have like a...
You bombard.
So there's like this whole like... lifestyle now that we live where we just send reels to each other.
Yeah.
Or like maybe it's just me sending them. It's not each other. But like I just send reels and you might send me reels and I'll never watch them. Right. But Merry Christmas. But I'll just send reels and I love it. And I don't care if you actually look at the reels that I send you, but what I send you is funny.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you're not laughing, at least I'm laughing. And that's how I look at it. Merry Christmas.
What you send is usually funny.
I'll say I try to be thoughtful. I try to be thoughtful with the Sharon.
Even though I don't, I definitely don't watch all
I'm a Karen. I'm not a Karen. I'm a Sharon.
You're a Karen. You're a caring Karen.
I'm a non-Karen Sharon.
Yeah. Well.
Is this it?
I'm exhausted.
You're white. Of course you are.
It's been a lot of, I'm so tired of talking about race. It's just, you don't understand how much it takes out of me. It's just,
I hurry nowhere. I never race anywhere.
It's my favorite race is the 100 meter freestyle. The race that I hate the most is probably one of those horse races where they make the horses race, because I don't believe in animal cruelty. That just seems, I just don't like that at all. So I hate those races. I hate any race that forces an animal to run. But I love the ones that where people swim. I feel like we should just say Merry Christmas.
That's probably the best thing you could say right now.
And a Happy New Year?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We didn't make it there yet, but like hopefully
we're not there yet. We're close. We're not gonna do another episode before the new year.
It's the last episode.
It's the last one ever. Yeah. Kenny's quitting. JoJo's gone.
I'm fucking out.
The next one is gonna be White Guy. It's just gonna be me and I'm gonna be like,
it's just one guy. One white guy. It's a lone white guy. It'd be like the lone white guy. So that's what you should do. It could be like not the Lone Ranger, but like the lone.
Yeah.
Retired.
Tonto.
Yo.
Tonto.
He fucking, dude, he's out.
Where's Tonto?
He said no, yo. He's out.
How have we not given JoJo the nickname Tonto yet?
That would be good.
When he comes back, that's his nickname.
All right, we'll go with Tonto.
JoJo, when you come back,
5% Tonto.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a gift for you, but you ain't here.
We'll have to, maybe we'll drive over to his house.
We'll do a drive-by. We'll throw it over, we'll throw it at him.
Or you could just drop it on the front porch. Be a total surprise. That'd be nice.
Yeah, be nice.
Yeah.
Not tonight, JoJo. Lit up like an old Christmas tree. It ain't happening. I got to drive myself silly.
And my pronouns are Zersey.
You're so invested.
Merry Christmas.
I love you guys.
White guys.
Happy holidays.
You got something to say? You got some funny shit? You got some, hold on, let's see what you got to say.